They were speaking about very important subject, luteal phase support in IVF ICSI. What's the etiology of this condition? In each cycle of ICSI or RT, there is luteal phase defects caused by either large quantity of gonadal cells removal during oocyte retrieval or due to HCG administration, which suppresses luteinizing hormone. And lastly, due to continued downregulation by gonadotropin releasing hormone agonist. Does the protocol affect both agonist and antagonist protocol require luteal phase defect and both require support? What is the option? There is a lot of option, either progesterone or HCG or estradiol or gonadotropin releasing hormone and lastly co-treatment. The classic support was progesterone. First is oral ingestion or oral route. Oral progesterone is extensively metabolized by the liver, so there is reduced bioavailability, except dihydrogesterone. However, the effect of oral is less effective than vaginal or intramuscular. In a study, there is dihydrogesterone versus progesterone for luteal support. Dihydrogesterone seems to be as effective as vaginal progesterone for luteal support in RT cycle. Intramuscular injections preferred route for administration, rapidly absorbed, peak level, and most reliable route to achieve desired concentration of progesterone in serum, especially in the serum and effect in the immune system. A dose between 50 to 100 milligram. Vaginal progesterone to reach high level of uterine concentration and despite low serum concentration. Another advantage, it does not cause drowsiness or sleepiness, but there is a problem of vaginal discharge. This picture shows that the intramuscular progesterone, there is high serum level, but low intravaginal level, but with vaginal progesterone, endometrial level is high, but lower in intramuscular route. Gel foam may be referred to the over suppository. There is no need to lie flat after insertion. Dose is 90 milligram daily. In comparison with utrogestan, there is a slight increase on rate of pregnancy rate with crinone low vaginal gel. Erectile is not widely accepted when there is no clinical trial about it. Timing of luteal support, when to begin, not later than 3 days after oocyte retrieval. HCG may cover about maximum 8 days, so you should prefer to begin 3 days after oocyte retrieval. Not delay it. If you about 1 day after oocyte retrieval, another opinion 2 days after oocyte retrieval. When to stop, minimum 2 weeks after the embryo transfer or 18 days after following oocyte retrieval. But most of opinion prefer to continue progesterone till 7 weeks. Another option is human chorionic gonadotropin. This is an indirect form to stimulate corpus luteum to produce progesterone. It does 1,050 to 2,000. And in comparison with progesterone, there is no apparent difference. Disadvantage increased rate of ovarian hyperstress syndrome may intervene with pregnancy test to know if the patient is pregnant or not. So the gene is not preferred if E2 level more than 2,500 on the day of HCG administration before oocyte retrieval, or the number of follicles more than 10. The third one is estradiol very late. This idea mostly we give only progesterone, But estradiol is low also in the luteal phase, which natural cycle view, fee high level of estrogen or steady level of estrogen in luteal phase. This is the idea to give estrogen in combination with progesterone. But the rule is not clear. The studies show that the difference in pregnancy rate between the two regimen of progesterone only or combined with estrogen is very small. Another one, the gonadotropin releasing hormone. This is support corpus luteum by stimulating secretion of LH by the pituitary, acting better with the ECG. You can add the DNA channel away, the pituitary will release luteinizing hormone. برضه هي افكت تاني ان ممكن acting in endometrium by locally expressed GnRH receptor also direct effect in embryos. Single dose given 5 days after ICSI. Results of Cochrane database systemic review. Oral route is associated with reduction of pregnancy rate, so it's not preferred. There is evidence of benefit of intramuscular over vaginal route in terms of outcome, ongoing pregnancy rate and life birth rate. Because the effect in serum is high and immunomodulation is more prominent than vaginal root. There is no significant difference in pregnancy between the vaginal gel and other type of preparation. There is no significant difference between progesterone or HCG or between progesterone and progesterone plus HCG or estrogen. Co-treatment, last option. Co-treatment, most of them, there is no solid evidence to use it as ascorbic acid. Steroid, no proven efficacy. Aspirin, controversial because it may increase blood flow. Sildenafil, also controversial. Low molecular weight heparin, anticoagulant effect, modulate blood cyst apposition, adherence, and division may benefit, but avoid routine use until further research. Granulocyte colon stimulating factor, promising role. Intravenous immunoglobulin reduced natural killer cell activity, lack of evidence. Atosiban may reduce uterine contractility, further study required. And lastly, neuromuscular electrical stimulation. Thank you very much.